All right, welcome you back, students, for another lecture on alcohols and phenols. What we are doing, students, what we are doing up to now, what we have been telling you is alcohols, phenols. We told you last time about certain chemical reactions of alcohols, students. Chemical reactions of alcohols and phenols. Okay? We started with that.
Yes, sir.
And the first thing we said, if you have ROH, what is the, or you have phenol, we were discussing the cleavage of OH bond. Or what we have been telling about the acidity of alcohols and phenols. Very, very important question will be there in the paper on the acidity of alcohols and phenols. So questions are going to be there on acidity of alcohols and phenols. Student, what you mean by this? All you are saying is that the alcohols, we said, can act as bronsted acids. That means they can give, if you have a bronsted acid, what is the meaning of that, student? All you are saying is, this is my alcohol. This is my alcohol, student. This is a bronsted acid, means something like this is happening. H plus is released, ionized. This is your acid. This is your conjugate base. And similarly, if I say phenol, student, phenol, then when I talk the phenol, student, this is my phenol. What happens, student? When this will release a proton, what you get? Here you have two pairs of electrons, students. So what you are getting? Phenoxide ion. And H plus. So this is acid, then this is the conjugate base. So you are using acid and conjugate base pair theory in order to account for the acidity of the alcohols and phenols. Yes, and sir. Very, very important results were there, because questions are going to, when we start comparing the acidity, students, the questions are going to be there. Comparing the acidity, which is more acidic, which is less acidic, how will we know? So it all depends on what conjugate base is being produced. If this conjugate base is very strong, then it will go back. Or in other words, if this conjugate base is strong, means it is not stable. If it is stabilized, if this conjugate base is stabilized by some method, student, then what will happen? Then it will go to the right hand side direction. When the conjugation will be stabilized, how the stabilization takes place? Because this, you see, there is a negative charge. There is a negative charge on this. So if a negative charge is more, then it will immediately react with H plus. That's it. It becomes a stronger conjugate base. It will react with the H plus to give
value. Yes, sir.
So stability, in other words, I can say that if I will compare the acidity, we already said that first thing we found that phenol is more acidic. Important question. Phenol is more acidic than CH3CH2O. Then alcohols. What reason we gave you for this, student? What was the reason for this? Because the phenoxide ion is resonance stabilized. We have shown you last time. The conjugate base of phenol is phenoxide ion, which is this one structure, if this is my one, I am talking of structure two here. ठीक है, so this is resonance stabilized. The result of that is this negative charge is not localized on the oxygen but is distributed over the entire benzene ring also. So what is happening, students? So the negative charge of the phenoxide ion is delocalized.
Yes, sir.
This negative charge, the negative charge is delocalized and is distributed over the entire benzene. You have seen ortho and para positions getting negative charge. So delocalization of the negative charge, so more stable, it becomes more stable. Therefore, we found phenol is more acidic as compared to, whereas OR minus, what happened in OR minus, student, OR minus, this is plus I. Electron releasing effect of this increases negative charge on oxygen, negative charge on oxygen atom, and therefore it is becoming stronger conjugate base, not becoming less stable. So we accounted for the acidity of phenol and few more things we found. Then you said that alcohols are weaker acid than water. But one exception was there. Alcohols are usually weaker acids. Then all the questions which have been asked are being discussed here by me. See, these questions have been, alcohols are weaker acid than water. Okay?
Yes, sir.
But what is the exception? Tell me which exception I told you. But there is one alcohol which is not weaker than water. Which was that? You have already in your notes last time you told you about methanol. Methanol exception is stronger than water. This was our exception which we discussed last time, students. So we have explained to you. Now the questions will be there. There are two things. You have noted down this. I will proceed further.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Copied.
Okay. Further important thing for because there is going to be a question on acidity of the phenol. Acidity of alcohol and phenol is always important. When I talk of acidity, student, there are two things which I define. How do I define the acidity of anything? You have seen, we talk of Ka values. What is the Ka values? How do we define the Ka value of any acid? If there is any acid, what we say, if you are saying, okay, this is my alcohol, there is an equilibrium between RO minus and H plus. Then what do you mean by Ka? You are saying RO minus concentration H plus divided by ROH. These are the molar concentration which gives us Ka. In other words, if Ka is large, will it be stronger or weak acid? Tell me. If Ka is larger, what it means, stronger or weaker acid? Students, keep on interacting with me, keep on talking with me. You have 30 seconds. If Ka is larger, it is a stronger or a weaker acid. Then that means stronger acid because there is more of this H plus.
Yes, sir.
Numerator is more.
Mm-hmm.
Then it is stronger acid. Numerator is more, then it is stronger acid. So H plus is more. What is the pKa? pKa was defined as minus log of K. So to the base 10. So what is the story here? If Ka is large, then pKa will be small. If pKa is larger, then what it means, stronger or weaker acid? Tell me.
Weaker, sir.
Weaker acid. Why we are saying all this? Because in exam, sometimes they may give you pKa values of two acids and then they ask you to find the reason why. Which is stronger acid? Why? Which is stronger acid? Why? Reasons have to be given every time. Because we are going to discuss the acidity and pKa values pKa values of alcohols and phenols. Because question will be there in the exam, student, on acidity, pKa values. Now, question is, phenol, orthonitrophenol, which is more acidic, why? Now we have started forming questions for the exam, which is more acidic, why? Okay, what is your answer? You have 1 minute.
Sir, orthonitrophenol is more acidic.
Now you have to give reason. More acidic than phenol. What is happening, student? The nitro group is strongly electron withdrawing. So what will it do? When strong electron groups are present, student, what will happen? What will be the result of that? So there will their negative charge will be delocalized on the phenoxide ion. There will be delocalization of negative charge. There will be delocalization of negative charge in phenoxide ion. In phenoxide ion. By N nitro group, by the nitro group, student, due to what is the effect of nitro? NO2 is electron withdrawing minus R effect. This is strongly electron withdrawing group, which is minus R effect. So all groups which are electron withdrawing will increase the acidity, students. Important point to note. That in general, we can say that, I can conclude that if electron groups are electron withdrawing groups, mainly at ortho para, because they can withdraw the electron density by resonance. Okay?
Yes,
they
sir.
Will increase the acidity. Acidity of phenols. And if electron releasing groups are present, what will happen? What will happen, students? Electron releasing groups. Electron releasing groups, student, they will decrease the acidity of the phenols. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So there will be questions based on that. You have noted down, then I will proceed further.
Copying.
Okay, copy it.
Copy it.
Okay. So the question is like this, student. You are given orthonitrophenol pKa, orthonitrophenol pKa 7.2, metanitrophenol is pKa 8.3. PKA
सर
means 10. 10. And you have paracrisol student PKA 10.2. Now you have to arrange in increasing exam. They may not give you PKA. I am giving you PKA.
Yes, sir.
Increasing order of acidity and explain. You have to give reason also. As you can see here, we already have given you the PKA values, which makes it clear that which is the strongest acid, which is the strongest acid here.
Yes, sir. So the lowest is phenol. Lowest is picrosol, then phenol, then nitrophenol, then O-nitrophenol.
Which is the strongest acid?
O-nitrophenol.
Lowest is phenol, but what is the highest value?
No, so I'm saying highest is O-nitrophenol.
And arrange the lowest.
Lowest is P.
Paracrisol.
Yes, sir.
You have paracrisol. This is the weakest. After that, you have phenol. After that, you have meta nitrophenol, which is least. Then you have ortho nitrophenol. This is the order.
Yes, sir.
What reason we are giving? Reason, what reason we are giving student for this? Tell
sir,
me.
Lower PKA value.
PKA value is not given, then what will you answer? Even we have to explain the PKA values.
Okay.
Or he can ask, explain the PKA values. It's a question for the paper students. How will you justify? You have to give reason. We have to give reason. When ortho, if I draw the structures of this, the story will become clear. What is crisol? What is crisol? Paracrisol. This is my paracrisol. This is my phenol. Paracrisol. Phenol. What is meta nitrophenol? And what is ortho nitrophenol? This is our ortho nitrophenol. So, meta. And this is our ortho nitrophenol. So, how do we explain now? How do we explain? What happens at nitro group is strongly electron withdrawing. At meta, the resonance does not take place. Only the electron withdrawing effect. So what happens at ortho nitro? When nitro is attached to at the ortho position, what is happening? It is strongly electron withdrawing. Which factor? Minus R as well as minus I. And when meta nitro means it is electron withdrawing by which factor? Electron with drawing only by inductive effect minus I. Resonance does not take place at meta, you know about that. And CH3 group, what is that? This is plus I electron release. Now you can explain, got it?
Yes, sir.
Electron withdrawing groups will increase the acidity. And stronger electron withdrawal takes place when there is a resonance, we know about it. But that operates only at ortho and para position. Student, meta position, that does not operate. So usually questions are given in the paper when they will be asking you to compare the acidity of the different alcohols or phenols. Students, we should be able to answer it. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, you note it down, then I will proceed further. In all our lectures, a lot of question answers will continue. Question answers will continue, student. We should be prepared for these question answer sessions.
Yes, sir. Continue.
Okay. Question was given in the paper, student, on acidity. On acidity, arrange the following in increasing order of acidity. Arrange the following increasing order of the acidity. You are given propan. One all two four six trinitro phenol three nitro phenol three five di nitro phenol. Phenol and next 4-methyl phenol. Okay, you have 2 minutes to answer the question, students.
Yes, sir.
First, you should be able to draw the structures of all this, then only answer should be given. Important point to note down. Such questions will be there in the paper always.
I'm doing, sir. Doing.
Done it.
Doing.
Okay.
Done, sir.
Okay.
Sir, the lowest is propane, one all.
Okay. You know what is the structures of these, but this is the structure of 1, 2, 3. Propane, one all is your CH2OH, CH3CH2, and 2, 4, 6 trinitrophenol. This is.
Yes, sir.
2, 4, 6, and 3 nitrophenol is my OH. 3 nitrophenol, 1, 2, and 3. Then this is at the nitro position. Then you have OH 3, 5. 1, 2, 3, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 5 done. Then you have phenol, and then you have methyl, 4-methylphenol is, which we call as paracrisol. These are the ones. Okay, then what is the lowest?
Sir, the lowest is propane vinyl.
Okay. So CH3, CH2, CH2OH is the lowest.
Yes, sir. Then 4-methyl phenol.
This is because this is what plus I effect, electron releasing, and these are minus I effects. Two. This is minus I effect one only. Two minus I one. And what is this? This is minus R and minus I strong. There are three of these. Three of these. There are three which can enter. So CH3, CH2H, then you have OH. After that, you have phenol. After that?
Sir, after that, we have phenol. Then we have 3-nitrophenol.
1, 2, 3.
Yes, sir. Sir, then we have 3,5-dinitrophenol.
Then,
and then you have 2,4,6-trinitrophenol. 2, 4, 6.
Okay. So we could understand how do we answer such questions. The reasons we already know, we have already given all electron withdrawing groups. They will increase the acidity and others will decrease the acidity. So one question on acidity will be there, students, which we already know how to solve it. Okay? Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. Acidity is the property which we have been talking is nothing but the properties is the cleavage of which one? OH bond. Oxygen is more electronegative, it takes the electron and H plus is out. That's what you are saying. This is all the acidic behavior of alcohols and phenols. That's what we were talking about.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Further important reaction which is coming, we were discussing the chemical reactions, students, and one more chemical reaction which is very, very important. This is asked is esterification. Esterification, students. What is esterification? We are saying alcohols and phenols, they react with carboxylic acids. React with carboxylic acids.
Yes, sir.
Or acid chlorides or acid anhydrides. Acid anhydrides to form esters. In the presence of acids, in the presence of student acids, H plus.
Yes, sir.
So this is important reaction, and esters have a fruity smell, you know, esters. They have a fruity smell. So this can be used as a test for alcohols. We may say it's a test for alcohol because alcohol reacts with carboxylic acid in the presence of H plus and there will be fruity smell. Now, what is the story of the reaction, student? What type of reaction is taking place here? Again, it is an example where the alcohol will, OH bond of alcohol will be cleaved. This is example again of where OH group of alcohol will be cleaved. What we are saying? ROH. This again involves this cleavage. So this is RO minus group, which is attaching with the carboxylic acid group. So what is happening? You have ROH, you have RC double bond OH group. This is your acid. This
yes, is sir.
Alcohol.
Hmm.
Let me make it R dash because this is R here. And you have H plus. Then what we are saying, the two are reacting. What will happen if I just see, this is the story. Minus H2O. OH is coming from carboxylic acid. H is coming from alcohol. The result is the formation of RCOR dash. And H2O, you are saying this is an ester student. Ester. This is an important reaction, students. Important reaction. The important point in this reaction is that the alcohol gives only H, and OH is coming from acid. Acid.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes we will say that OH is coming from here, H is coming from here. What was done? The reaction was given like this: R dash OH 18 plus this is 18 isotope. O 18 is an isotope of the oxygen. This is called isotope labeling.
Okay, sir.
Experimentally, they have seen it by using isotopic labeling. But in the exam, they are saying, students, that R O H 18 isotope of oxygen is reacting with R C double bond O H in the presence of what? H plus. You have to write the products. Here he has mentioned RO 18. RO 18, student, what? They want to see what product you write because there is an isotope of oxygen which has been labeled. There's no labeling here. So when I write, what will be the product? RC, experimentally, it has been verified. Let me put it this, because both are R here, both are R group. Let it be R, doesn't matter to me. So students, you are getting this and H2O. Now which oxygen has got 18 isotope? Where is that oxygen? Where is that oxygen? Which oxygen has got 18? This one or this one? That was the point. Whether 18 yes, is sir. Here or here.
Mm-hmm.
Only one oxygen is O18. So how will we know which is coming? As I said, this bond is breaking. H, and this OR is then, and carboxylic acid is giving you what? RC double bond O. That is what we are saying. The reaction takes place like this. So where this then OTN should be here. Okay, this oxygen 18 oxygen will be in this group, not here. That was the question. Important point, students, where the H comes from, where the OH comes from, when such a reaction takes place, when such a reaction.
Yes.
It's a point to be noted. This is a question in the paper. Point to be noted. Note it down. But it proves that the alcohol OH bond is cleaved. And for the carboxylic acid, OH bond is carbon oxygen bond is cleaved for carboxylic acid. We'll note down, then I will proceed further.
Copying, sir.
Okay. Important question, students. Certain questions are very, very important. Esterification is important question will be asked. This I am putting star, important reaction, esterification, ester formation. I am not going into the mechanism of this at this stage because it is not required. That we are discussing in YouTube, separate equations and larger number of organic equations and their mechanism differently in a different videos.
I'm copied, sir.
Okay. All right. We are proceeding further, student. What we said that you have, supposing you have CH3OH. This is our alcohol. And you react this with CH3, CH2, C double bond OH. In the presence of acid, then we are seeing CH3OH. You can also react with CH3, C double bond O, O, C double bond O, CH3. What is this? Anhydride. These are called anhydride, students. Anhydrides. And you can react CH3, CH2OH plus with CH3, CH2COCl. You have to write the products. You have to write the product, student. You have,
yes, sir,
1 minute for each question. These reactions are actually reversible. Usually a base is used here, they say pyridine or something like that. So this is important, what you will get, CH3, CH2, C, double bond O, OH is out, what group is here, OCH3. And H2O, what will happen here? What will happen here? You have now this group will be out, and what will you get? CH3, C double bond O, O, CH3, and then what will happen to this group? CH3, COOH. What will happen here? You have this acid chloride, HCl will be lost. So what will you get? CH3, CH2, C double bond O, O, CH2, CH3 plus HCl. All these esters. And we have told you these esters have fruity smell. So you know how the reactions are taking place whenever I write CH3, CH2, C double bond O, OH, and you have alcohol. Then what we told you, this group is how H plus takes place. This always gives OH, this gives H. Then you have to combine, as we have shown the products. And here you have seen that this is giving H, OH, and this is giving this product. And similarly, if I have to write this reaction, we should know CH3, CH2, C double bond O, you have Cl, and if I take CH3, CH2, O, H, then this is the story here, minus HCl. So this group will get attached to this carbon. Got it? How we write the reactions? Important reaction, esterification.
Yes, sir.
The important questions are given on esterification. We are saying that the hydrogen is given by the alcohol and OH is given coming from the carboxylic acid, which we have proved experimentally by isotopic labeling. by isotope labeling, we can find out the. And this fruity smell will be there. I have not discussed the mechanism in here. This is discussed in a separate YouTube video. If one is interested, one can go into it. One more important reaction is very, very important reaction question. Very important question. For example, this reaction is very important. Write the product, student. In this case, very important question. You know what is the name of this compound? What is the name of this? 1,2 hydroxybenzoic acid, 2 hydroxybenzoic acid. This is also called.
Yes, sir.
Salicylic acid. Salicylic acid, student, very important compound. This example of acetylation of salicylic acid.
Yes, sir.
And you know what is the product? Very important product. What is the answer? Again, if I open this. And this is my alcohol. And what is happening? See. H3 C double bond O, and what do you have? C double bond O. There's an oxygen. Some wait a minute. Let me see.
Yes.
CH3C double bond O, O C double bond O, CH3. This is acetic anhydride. What do you call acetic anhydride? What will happen? This H will go with what? What will happen? So what will be there then? This hydrogen gives H. This gives, just as in the carboxylic acid, it was giving OH, OCOCH3. So what will be the product then? What will be the product? COOH. You have one oxygen attached with C double bond OCH3.
Yes, sir.
This reaction is what we call as acetylation of salicylic acid. Acetylation of salicylic acid. And what is this product coming out? CH3COOH. What is the name of this compound? Aspirin. That's why I give you aspirin. That's aspirin which you are eating for headaches and fevers. Aspirin. This is aspirin, student, which you are using for fevers and headaches. This is acetyl salicylic acid. Acetylation of salicylic acid. Acetyl salicylic acid. What you are getting, student? Acetyl salicylic acid. What do you get? Acetyl salicylic acid. So when you write the very important product, very important reaction, convert salicylic acid into aspirin or acetyl salicylic acid, what you are getting? OCOCH3 plus CH3COOH. This is a very important reaction which I have shown here. Very important reaction, students.
Yes, sir.
What I am trying to tell you that what type of questions can be there in the paper. We are trying to give you more and more practice of the questions which are going to be there in the papers. one question is always there on the acidity. There are so much variety of that question in the NCERT book also. Esterification is always asked to the students in the exam that ester formation is important and which reaction takes place, which bond is broken, students. That is a part which we have to be very, very clear in order to show the reactions. For example, you have phenol. And you are reacting with CH3, CH2, COOH, H plus. What will be the product? What will be the product, students? How will you write the product if I put it like this? CH3, CH2, C.
Yes, sir.
H double bond O. What is going to happen then? You know, this will be out. Then what you are getting? CH3, CH2, C double bond O. O. This one, what I write, say, phenyl or OC6H5 or benzene ring. What is the product? Phenyl. What is the IUPAC name of this? This group is PH, na? Benzene ring. So what is the IUPAC name of this? H plus. These are all esterification reaction, ester formation reaction, students. Phenyl, how many carbons? 1, 2, 3. So what will be the name of this phenyl propanoate? Is the ester of phenyl propanoate. Clear?
Clear, sir.
All right. This ends one part of the reactions. Now we have to discuss the second part of the reaction, which is again a topic, separate topic. We will continue with that next time because we will start with the cleavage of carbon-oxygen bond reactions. This was all the cleavage of OH bond reactions of the alcohols and phenols. Next time we will do the cleavage of the carbon-oxygen bond. Because it's a separate topic, so we will continue that in the next class. All right, then keep on practicing and solving questions. We will meet you in the next class. Noted down everything?
Yes, sir. Copying. Anyways, thank you, sir.
Okay, you can copy everything. No problem. Copy.
Yes, sir. Then I'll leave the meeting after copy.
Okay. Copy everything.